the way for the Lord. Make straight in the wilderness a highway for our God. Every valley shall be raised up, every mountain hill made low. The rough ground shall become level, the rugged places a plain. And the glory of the Lord will be revealed, and all mankind together will see it. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken.
Oh,
census should be taken of the entire Roman world. Everyone went to his own town to register. But Joseph also went out from the town of Nazareth and Galilee to Judea and Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him, and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in a cloth and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them.
Thank you.
the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." from the east came to Jerusalem. They had seen a star in the east and had come to worship him. The star went ahead of them till it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold and of incense and of myrrh.
Thank you. So losing my voice, so I will. Yes. Might be a really short sermon tomorrow, I tell you. Part of the Advent season is to prepare ourselves for the gift of Jesus. And so we hope that we've helped you do that. I know that for my congregation, it's probably joyous here tonight because I don't let them sing a lot of Christmas songs before Christmas. I want them to know that Christmas hasn't arrived yet. And I want you to know that Christmas hasn't arrived yet. A lot of times we forget that. And Christmas Day gets here and we're ready to put everything back in a box. And it's not. We're in a season of preparing. So I hope we were able to do that. I want you to understand that we were able to do this tonight because of clusters and four churches coming together. So with that, let us pray. God, we know that you are an awesome God. You sent us this gift, wrapped in swaddling clothes, born in poverty, with no place to call home, laying in a manger. And as that gift grew into a man, he changed the world. Not only did he change the world in which he lived back 2,000 years ago, he continues to change the world today because he changes us when we get to know him. And so we give you thanks for this amazing gift that we celebrate this Christmas season. We ask that you continue to open our hearts and our minds to all that you have for us so that we can grow in our understanding of who Christ was then, who Christ still is today, and who Christ calls us to be as he calls us to be his disciples in the world. This Christmas season, help us remember that that is what we are celebrating, this awesome gift. We ask that you continue to lead and guide us. We may be your beacon of light here in this place, that we may feel your spirit at work here in this season, even amongst all of the chaos. We ask this because of your amazing